Today, we are introducing a new model called Unilumos. What is this model for? It is a relighting model or a relighting model. Relighting refers to migrating the lighting and shadows from the background onto the character. Therefore, once relighting is involved, background replacement must also be performed. You can also see through these examples that we can take a character in a video, replace the background, and at the same time let the lighting and shadows on the character change along with the background replacement. Some people might ask, why is this model not called a background replacement model? There are actually some differences between a relighting model and a background replacement model. Background replacement models, in addition to requiring relighting, also require the foreground, the character, and the background to blend together perfectly. However, relighting only considers the migration of lighting and shadows, not perfect blending. Currently, we can already use this model within ComfyUI. Kijai has implemented this model in the WAN video extension. You can open its example workflow. We can see that there is a workflow here called Unilumos Relight. You can upgrade the WAN video extension to the latest version and then simply drag this workflow into your ComfyUI. You can download the corresponding model using the provided URL. You will notice that this model is actually a 1.3B model. Its size is only 2.84 gigabytes. Therefore, we might guess that the quality of this model won't be very high. Does that mean this model is worthless? It is perhaps too early to say that. Next, let's look at how this model should be used in practical applications. I have also set up the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform via Running Hub. In the ComfyUI field, Running Hub is an excellent online workspace because whenever new models or new extensions appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which grants you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, logging into Running Hub every day provides 100 bonus credits, allowing you to try out your own workflows. Now, let's look at this workflow. This workflow can generally be divided into three parts: the traditional 2.1 model workflow, the processing of the background, and the processing of the foreground. Now, let's look at them one by one. First, let's look at the main model loading. Note that the model we are loading is the Unilumos 1.3B model we just discussed. Then we have an acceleration LoRa here. This LoRa we are using is the COSVID 1.3B acceleration LoRa. Following that are the text encoder and VAE, which are no different than usual. Regarding the prompt section, it is not particularly important in this workflow. You can write it or not. The most important parts are actually these two sections. First is the foreground section. The foreground is essentially the video we want to replace. This video shows a beautiful woman singing while holding a guitar. Note that the overall background is inside a room, and the overall lighting and shadows are very beautiful. Similarly, we first resize it. I have set the size to 832 by 480. Note the several connected nodes here. These nodes are used to process our foreground first. There is a node for removing the background. This gives us the mask of the foreground character. Then we invert this mask, which gives us the mask for the background. We then use a neutral gray color value to paint the background. So the final foreground processing effect you see looks like this. We then encode the foreground into our latent space, where it will be used during sampling. Next, let's look at the background. Generally, the background does not contain people. It is an environment video. Similarly, we resize it according to our resolution. Below this, there is a very important node. The function of this node is to draw Gaussian noise onto the background. The basis for drawing is, of course, the foreground character. Therefore, you will find that after drawing is complete, we get a video like this. The Gaussian noise is the part you see now. We also encode this into our latent space. In this way, we obtain two latents. One is called the foreground latent, and the other is called the background latent. We connect these to the new node, One Video Unilumos Embed, which generates an image embed, or what we call the image embedding vector. We then proceed to sampling because the acceleration model is used. The number of steps is set to 6, CFG is 1, and the sampling algorithm we use is LCM. After this, we get the resulting video. If you look at the effect of this video, it is actually not particularly good, as we mentioned earlier, that it is just a 1.3B model. However, it is undeniable that the lighting effect is still acceptable. Note the character's skin, the edge of the hair, the change in the guitar's overall color tone, and the reflections on it, all of which reflect the lighting effect of the overall background. Nevertheless, such a video is meaningless for practical application, but it solves a very important problem. Previously, almost all models we used, such as Wan Animate or Mocha, essentially performed foreground replacement. There were almost no models that performed background replacement. Therefore, among the many good quality models, even though this model's quality is not very high, its application is unique. So once we have this video, we can perform subsequent processing. We know that among all the models we have discussed, the one with the best performance in terms of lighting and shadows is Mocha. Therefore, we can use Mocha to perform a secondary processing on this video. Look at this workflow. Now we already have an original video, then we select the original video we just generated as the reference image for character replacement. Let's briefly look at this workflow. The biggest feature of Mocha is the mask. We only need to get the mask for the first frame and do not need to process the mask for the entire video. So we take the first frame and use the point editor to select the character. After sampling, you will find that the quality is much better. In particular, the character appears more natural. Note the lighting and shadows in this area, how the firelight reflects on the character's arm and hair. This detail is much finer. Moreover, the character's skin will not be so red. Note that in the original video, the character's overall skin appearance was unnatural. If you look at our process result, it is much better. However, we have also mentioned that the Mocha model is still slightly lacking in terms of the realism of the character's depiction. Its greatest advantage lies in the reflection of lighting and shadows. Some people might ask, what if I want to make it even better? You can use the Wan 2.2 low noise model for optimization. Look, this is a repair workflow using the Wan 2.2 low noise model. This workflow is actually very simple. I used a loop here, but this loop is unnecessary here. It is only needed for long videos. Since this video only has 49 frames, we can just run it once. If you look at this workflow, you can consider the Wan 2.2 T2V workflow with the high noise model removed. First, we use our reference video, take the first frame, and use Q003VL to perform prompt inversion. This is because in Wan 2.2, the prompt has a very significant impact on the video. This way, we get a very detailed prompt. In the model loading section, note that I only used the low noise model, enabled Sage attention, and enabled light X to V acceleration. The text encoder and VAE remain unchanged. Next is the sampling stage. The sampling stage actually only involves low noise sampling. However, you should note that it is not a sampling with an intensity of 1. It starts from step 6 and ends at step 8. If you were to switch to the denoise option, that would be 0.25 because I am only performing a repair on this video and not a regeneration. Now let's look at the effect after the repair. At this point, you will find that the lighting and shadows are much more natural, and the character's face has also become prettier. Almost all details look fine. Here, I need to remind everyone, if you run Kijai's workflow directly, it might result in an error. The reason is that the background video currently only has 49 frames. If your foreground video and background video are different in length, it will definitely cause an error. Therefore, remember to standardize and only use 49 frames. Do not take it for granted and try to sample with 81 frames. Let's briefly summarize. We used the Unilumos model as a foundational model to first generate a base video of lower quality. Then, we performed an optimization using Mocha to make the character look more natural. Finally, we performed another repair using the Wan 2.2 low noise model. This repair primarily had two goals. First, to make the overall image look prettier, and second, to increase the resolution. Note that I have now upscaled it to 1280 by 720. Therefore, even though the inherent quality of the Unilumos model is not high, you can achieve a video of very good quality through a series of steps. What are you waiting for? Go try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.